human beings. We have animals. We have plants.
And scientists now generally they say these are living things.
Now, non-living things, جماد. حيوان وإنسان وجماد. And then, what about جماد means non-living things, supposedly, non-living entities. All these things make tasbih to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is a point that we have to understand and we have to go a little bit beyond the meaning.
What do we mean that a nabat, the plants, the animals, even non-living things make tasbih to Allah?
Do they have a language? Do animals have a language? Do plants have, okay, we said that animal God.
Do plants have a language? Do non-living things, iron and wood and dust and sand, do they have a language? Let's go, start with the first one, الحيوان,
the animals.
Now, if you go and research to those of you who are interested in animals and zoology, they say that these, not only speak, they also write.
No, 0% literacy among bees.
All bees, they read and write.
Some people don't think about human bees, they can't read or write.
How do they read and write? Scientists say, number one, they speak by moving their bodies and their tongues. That's how they communicate. Because language, when they say, you said that. That means he has a language that understands. Because language, what? A language is a medium of communication. That's what a language is. To convey meanings. You use a language to convey meaning from one meaning to another. You use mediums of communication to communicate. We are not the only ones who have these mediums of communications and these languages. The bees do. And they move themselves in certain shapes that is a sort of, that's a form of communication. They communicate to the rest of the bees. This is what you should do. Not only that, they leave written messages. So here, please do this. One bee says to the other, huh? By secreting chemical substances. They secrete a chemical substance that is indicative, that is a communication with the other bees to do this.
This bees, subhanAllah, and you said to me that. This is the reason, because the beginning of the ayah, you said to me that, ma fi samawat, wa ma fi al-ard. Hey, this little bee that we don't know about.
Now, more on that, the ants.
The little ants that some people step even on when they walk. This little ant.
Now the science say that ants, among other things, ants also talk and they have languages. They even have three languages.
Basically trilinguals. Every ant is trilingual by nature. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trilingual. And now they say that now, this 1424 years after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
and we in the Quran, we said that Allah said in the Quran that ants talk. قالت نمنا يا أيها النمل كل مساكنكم
سليمان
عليه السلام and the ant, didn't she tell the rest of the ants go up to your houses?
قالت نمنا why the
why? It's not, the Quran said all these things really. If these scientists go back to the Quran, they will find all these things written in the Quran.
Right.
This we said, okay, fine. There ants and all these things. How about plants?
Plants talk. Yes, plants do talk. The plants talk.
And the plants talk, and they not only they talk, they actually change color. You know when you go to one place, you change color, you put power on fire. So the plants communicate with their environment. And depending on their environment, they change their attributes. Not only that, scientists now prove. And go, please research these things. And I want you to research these things. Why? So you can understand the greatness of Allah. You can't really understand, but you can understand part of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can appreciate your message that you're carrying of tawheed. That these ants, they feel the surroundings around them. If you damage a tree next to that tree, this tree eventually knows what happened next to it. And it changes its attributes based on that change that happened around it. Communication right away.
Open full mind, I bet. Somebody cut me. Cut the tree, please be careful. So plants talk. And I will take your hearts to your brother. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And the Prophet Mustafa, the Prophet Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so you don't think that plants don't talk. And hadith is narrated by Bukhari. Remember when the three moved towards him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do cats talk or not? Wallahi they talk. Now science tell they talk. But the hadith of Bukhari, long time ago they talk. And they have feelings also. And the jibba alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the three came towards him, this is only not only that they talk and communicate, they have feelings as well. So maybe we should make first international plant rights. Feelings they have also. I understand. طيب. هاي الحيوان والنبات والجماد. جماد themselves are fine. Living things. Non-living things. Like dust, like soil, like sand, like iron, like wood. Do these things? We may think that these things are silent or they're still. But you know that this sand that we're standing on right now contains a violent movement. Potential energy in there, violent movement, you can change the energy into a huge blast. This electrons and neutrons and protons are moving into that violent movement. If you're thinking you're standing on a sand that stands still, then you're fooling yourself. There is a communication and there is a form of living and all these things. So what they classify as non-living entities, this is really ambiguous and this is really questionable. What is non-living? What is living? Who knows? Huh? Not only that, I will also take your hearts to your beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Habib Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will also give you this, and you all know it, al-hasa, the stones. Didn't they have tasbih in his hand, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? مَسَبَّحَ الْحَصَى بِيَدِهِ صَلَوَاتِ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْهِ. Yes, al-hasa with tasbih in his hands. He heard them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, making tasbih. Al-hasa, actually, the brothers and sisters made tasbih in everybody's hands. But the Prophet understood the method and the way they make tasbih. He heard them making tasbih. You may take that piece of sand and you don't know what it's doing. But Allah Jalla wa'ala said in the Quran, إِن كُلُّ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. Everything that tasbih to Allah. ولا تتفقون تسبيحه. The Quran says, maybe you don't understand the way they make tasbih. Because this is a language. And the language, you have to understand it. Now, many times among human species, we don't want to go into other categories like plants and animals and things. But among the human species, you get people from China, you get people from Japan, you can understand what they're saying. You can understand what they're saying unless you have actual knowledge of this. So because we don't have knowledge of this, we can't understand what they're saying. Well, maybe the same thing applies. Our intelligence is still limited. We cannot understand how these rocks and how these sands and how these plants and how this wood is really tasbih to Allah Jalla wa'ala. We shouldn't just discount this because, oh, I don't know. Well, we don't know it. There are so many things that human beings still don't know. So many things. Actually, they're beginners. Human beings is a beginning, subhanAllah. Always a beginning. But yet you see human beings, what? Walking in arrogance. Walking in arrogance like there's no tomorrow, like there's nobody better than me. This is how we walk. The entire human being with all this and all this greatness that the human being attributes himself. One little fly like this, one little mosquito comes in and this big and huge and muscles and arms and power takes his head, puts it in the sand. One little mosquito. Dips his head in the sand, but kills him. Nothing. But the human beings, subhanAllah subhanAllah, created them like that, especially those who don't have weak, of course, and those who don't have iman and belief, they fall into this. Well, you have been a paraway of this. But now you said before bihamdih, the ayah has another meaning to it that we should actually see. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting who? يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Everything. Everything is what? Humans, angels, plants, animals, sands, things. You know what that means? That is equalizing everybody. You, the human being, the most intelligent thing, as far as we think, of course. We don't know that. If we are actually the most intelligent species, we can't prove that. But of course we think, so, because we can write, maybe the ants that write about us, they say, these people are dumb. How do we know? Because we don't know. But, so, because we write, we say, okay, fine, we are. But Allah said, when I put everybody at the same level, says, you said, people, you are, everything, all of them. بس
تعالى الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله تعالى رضي عنه says the sack تعالى fooled me the fox تعالى means fox he said the fox fooled me الإمام الشافعي رضي الله عنه said how said one time I went with two of my friends